Hey, this is Anil Khwaja. I'm a resistant migration agent, CEO and founder of ThinkHack Consultants. I have today Jason, who is the onshore coordinator at the International Student Recruitment Department at CIT. So, Jason, welcome to ThinkHack.
Thanks, Anil.
Yeah. So today we would be asking lots of questions regarding CIT, what are the upcoming intakes, what courses we can do, and lots of other stuff about the CIT. So first of all, Jason, I would like to know like the introduction of the CIT, what exactly the CIT is and mm-hmm. how long you've been working there. And so
yeah,
on, so
sure.
Yeah.
Well, the key point is that we are the TAFE in Canberra, okay? Every state and territory, every state has a TAFE. So we are the government vocational school in the ACT, the Australia
right.
Capital Territory.
Yeah.
Okay, so that's key. We're not, that sets us apart from the private providers. Okay, so we are the largest vocational institution in the ACT, okay?
Right.
The Australia Capital Territory, or Canberra as it's known, is over 400,000 people, okay? And so having that reputation with industry is very important. It helps the students, okay? We've been a trade school since for over 90 years, since 1928. So CIT has that reputation with Canberra, the industry, and that helps students because it's industry that dictate, you know, what courses are available, what training needs, what are their training needs. So they come to us and they say, we need more chefs, we need more people with these, you know, skills in hairdressing or building and construction. And so, and that's also important because most of our courses for the international students include an industry placement. Okay, so that leads to jobs, part-time, casual jobs, and that's invaluable, and that's part of the real, you know, the real world experience that they're going to get at a vocational
Absolutely.
College. Yeah.
So the Canberra Institute of Technology is like under the one roof. So that's what it is. Yeah, we are getting the placements. We have lots of opportunity for industry. Basically, CIT is like, you know, you get all options under one roof, and Canberra Institute of Technology is, as Jason told us, that it's a TAFE in ACT, and it's been there for so long, so lots of affiliation and association with the industry.
Mm-hmm.
And
many industries.
Absolutely, many industries, and, you know, heaps of options and opportunities for international students.
Yes, we have over 80 qualifications for international.
So it's a big, it's a very vast area mm-hmm. of industries which CIT is covering at the moment.
And I need to make it clear, so we have certificate threes, certificate fours,
yeah.
Diplomas and advanced diplomas.
Right.
We don't have bachelor programs.
All right.
Okay, I need to make that clear.
Oh, wonderful. Yeah. All right. So the second one, let's come to the second question. So what are the strengths of the CIT? Why students should choose CIT?
Yep.
So we have already discussed about that one, so I need you to be more specific and why international students choose CIT.
Yeah, so like I said, the support that you get in your industry placement, which can lead to work, student support. We're a large TAFE, so we have great support for students
right.
from welcoming you at our international student orientation with our international student advisors. They work together with the teachers of all the colleges called the head of those areas for international students is called the pastoral care officers. So they make sure that all the international students are meeting their requirements for their visa. If they need extra study support, English training. So we've got in-house, so we've got the library support, the drop-in student sessions. We've got counseling, free counseling from trained counselors. We've got a great organization called the CIT Student Association, or CITSA.
Yeah.
Now they're a nonprofit organization, a community organization that run all the commercial activities
right.
for CIT.
Yeah.
The canteens,
yeah.
the cafes, the bookshop,
yeah.
They're doing the events center now. They're doing graduation. They're managing the accommodation on
yeah.
campus
yeah.
now. They have student support officers that connect our students to the greater Canberra community, most importantly, employment opportunities and accommodation resources. So support. Students are going to find what they need to help them out at CIT. We have small class sizes, okay? So as a TAFE, as a vocational school, it's all hands-on learning, okay? Class sizes are very small, no more than 15, sometimes less, no more than 20 in a lot of cases.
Yeah.
And so small class sizes, you're going to get that one-on-one help from your teacher that way.
So wonderful. So CIT, if you go to CIT, they will definitely take care of all your needs as an international student, along with heaps of different facilities, which Jason has just mentioned. It's about that. So Jason, let us know about the how many campuses do you have, and what are the location of the campuses?
At CIT, we have five locations, okay? But two of them are where the international students study. They're our largest campuses, okay? We have two learning centers in other suburbs, north and south, where students, all students, international, can access the student and academic services there, okay? But all their courses will be either at the Bruce campus or the Reed campus. Now, the Bruce campus is in, it's a Belconnen suburb, okay? It's across the road from University of Canberra, which is one of the largest universities in getting there in Australia, actually. And so a lot of students are in that suburb area. Now, that's 20 minutes away from the city center, which is where our Reed campus is, our largest campus, and that's a 5-minute walk from the bus interchange, okay? We have a new video, actually, which it shows those two campuses and all the facilities, and there's just lots there. It's not just where your classes are. On the Reed campus, for example, we have a restaurant open for the public, a cafe open for two cafes for the public. They do weddings and events and everything there, conferences. We have a hairdressing and beauty salon. We've got, the art and design courses are there, an exhibition space. The English Language Center is there, and this is what I love about TAFE, okay? Because it's working with industry and putting them out in the real world. So we have 7 commercial training kitchens at the Reed campus, okay? Including a kitchen stadium, which we bring in chefs from around the world and do the filming and everything. Yeah,
sort of a master chef.
Exactly, like a master chef. We've actually done a reality cooking show with our media program with the hospitality school.
Yeah.
But so the chefs are always cooking food, and we have the apprentice kitchen that international students included in that. They sell the food that is prepared. So $3, $4, $5 meals, you can stock your freezer up. You can go to the hair and beauty salon and get your nails done, get a hot stone massage. The Bruce campus has a remedial massage clinic and a Fit and Well gym. I utilize those all the time. So it's for the public, and it's really good training for the students, and good for students on a budget to take advantage of those services too.
So in a nutshell, it's a state of art, you know, both of the campuses, and all the amenities are there, and you can use whatever you wanted to do as per your needful. And so that's wonderful to know. So what sort of programs are offered by CIT? I know that you told us that it's been more than 80 programs you offer.
80 qualifications.
What are the main qualifications and the most famous ones?
Okay, so the most famous ones are the most popular ones are commercial cookery, or which gets you a diploma or advanced diploma in hospitality management, but trains you to be a chef, certified chef in Australia. Early childhood education and care. This is another 2-year diploma program, and We have a childcare center, another training center on the Bruce campus for those students to get extra training before they go into their industry placement. And nursing, okay? Diploma of nursing is very popular as well. Now, all three of those courses have 4 intakes a year, okay? All the other courses that I alluded to, they have two intakes or 1 intake a year. So those are popular, and that for that reason we have 4 intakes a year.
So they have covered all of the courses, and the great part is like these all occupations are in the Canberra list as well. So if you're looking for later down the line to apply for like say 189s or 190-491, you have an opportunity for that one, because obviously that's what the Canberra State at this moment is looking for, the people who wanted to do such trades. Tell us about the entry requirements and what are the English requirements for these courses.
Okay, so for the majority of our courses, you need an equivalent of an IELTS 5.5, okay, with no band score less than 5. Okay, that's the low end, okay? For commercial cookery, you need the equivalent of a 5.5 with all band scores 5.5. So actually, these three popular courses actually require a little higher than that, okay? Early childhood education and care, that's an advanced levels or an equivalent of a 6.0 IELTS with no band score less than 5, okay? And like all diploma or all nursing programs, whether it's enrolled nurse or bachelor or the bachelor, the registered nurse in Australia, because it's nationwide, you have to meet the academic IELTS or PTE academic, so the academic IELTS of 7.0 across all bands. That's a PTE of 65 across all bands. And you must get that before you enroll in your course, okay?
I think it's been really recently implemented by that PROC, I believe.
Exactly. And so, because we are, recognized by APRA, our enrolled nurses, when they finish that diploma, they can apply for that registration.
Wonderful. That's great to know. So how many intakes we have available each year? Is there any specific intakes for different courses?
So I did mention those three courses, the cookery, childcare, and nursing. They have 4 intakes a year, February, April, July, and October, okay? We just started our February intake. All courses that we have on offer are available in February, okay? In July, okay, basically all of our courses are available except all the art and design courses, fashion, building design, interior design, visual art, photography, that is only 1 February intake each year, okay? And then we have a year 12 program, a 1-year year 12 program that is only in February as well. So.
So that's for both onshore and offshore? So those who are onshore and offshore can apply on these intakes.
Exactly.
And pretty much all over the year. So if you have missed failed intake, obviously you have an opportunity to go with the next intake.
We'll talk about English, but there are different intakes for English.
Alright, okay, cool. So any pathways for these programs, like any degree pathways, or if the student wants to do a diploma and then go to the University of Canberra, are there any pathways for that?
So we have accreditation pathways, okay, with most of them will be with our partner University of Canberra, okay? We have our course guide here, and we have a list of study pathways, right? So, for example, so not all the courses will have an accreditation, okay? But for instance, if you do 2 years to finish the advanced diploma of graphic design, okay, you can get into the third year of the Bachelor of Design, Visual Communication Design at University of Canberra. So that's a 2+1, okay? So there's various ones like that, interior design, But then we also have like our accounting goes into University of Canberra.
Yeah.
Our two diplomas of IT right. go into University of Canberra, and building and construction diplomas as well. Right. And early childhood education care, we have students going into University of Canberra or ACU, as well as the nursing, okay? Now, it's always advised that you check with the university before you commit, okay? Now, we don't, and we don't facilitate a package, okay? But students are welcome to apply through you guys to get this the COE, the offer letter, and then lodge a separate application, okay? And that's the preference from the universities, okay?
Yeah. It's good to know that most of the courses, which are popular ones, have the the university pathways. And as advice, we need to speak to the university as well, that whether the articulation is still in
still
in
current.
Exactly. And how many credit transfer you're going to get.
So
it depends on case to case and the discretion of the university as well. So we need to check that out. All right. So. What are the course outcomes for the students? Because we have seen that lots of CEIT students are job ready. Mm-hmm. As you told them, you have lots of associations with different industries as well.
Mm-hmm.
So once a CEIT graduate goes out in the industry, so what challenges he or she can get and how early they can grab the jobs?
Well, a lot of the courses include an industry placement, like I said before, and so a lot of the students are working in the industry before they even finish. Okay, so there you go, right? So that's a plus right there. Other courses that don't include an industry placement. Let's talk about the diploma of building and construction, building or management. Okay, there's no industry placement there, but through our connections with industry, and through the course, because the course includes like the white card and the asbestos card or qualification. That's what you need to work in the industry. So throughout the course, they do a lot of site visits. We have over a half dozen building industry partners. That's a hiring event. That's a hiring opportunity for those companies when the students come. And so that prepares them, that gives them the opportunity to ask more questions and possibly get a construction job part-time while they're working. So we're training them for the specific jobs. We can't guarantee, after they finish their course, because there's other visa issues involved in that, but they're very well prepared, and the majority of our students are already working in the industry by the time they finish.
So it's add a great value to your resume and CV if you do the courses from CID, but obviously it depends on individual skills and obviously your visa conditions, but that's where agents like us can help you out getting the visa sorted for you, and you get an opportunity to then work in Australia and whatever the pathways are, so that we can discuss further. So as we spoke already about the jobs and all, so now let's come to the main point. Like, lots of international students are very concerned about the fee. So what are the fee structure and what the initial deposit towards the COEs, and what are the costs associated with that?
Okay, so generally to get a COE, you need to pay at least the first semester. Okay, and that could range at the moment from $6,850 to $8,400. The top end is the commercial cookery course. There are some courses like those popular ones, nursing, childcare, and cookery. Those are term-based at the moment. Okay, so those will be term installments, half a semester to get the COE. Okay, and we work with you to for onshore.